Right, Darren, just start off, RFA Cup run starts in a few weeks' time. We've been drawn away to Potter's Bar. Just what's your reaction following that one?
Oh, brilliant. Absolutely perfect for the fans. Nice local derby. So looking forward to it. Really, really thrilled by it, obviously, with it being so close and a neighbour of ours. We'll be able to take a few fans and hopefully get the result that sets us off on a journey similar to the one we went on last season.
Can this competition be a bit of a feel-good factor for the boys and the fans and give us something to sort of cheer about this season?
Well, listen, I'll approach it how I approached cup games last year. You know, I want to get as far as I can in all cups that we enter, and I want to win as many league games as I can. So I won't be looking at it any other way than how I did last season. You know, I'll put out as strong as possible team as I can, because it was so much fun last year. Obviously, it took its toll on the league campaign because we ended up with several Saturday Tuesdays, but you know, that's part and parcel of being successful. You need to win as many games as you can, and I love the FA Cup, so I will be trying my hardest to get as far as we did last year.
Back onto the league action now. Obviously, today's the start of a very important week. Just how big can this week be for the club with two huge games coming up?
Yeah, they're big games, and I understand that everyone will make them into really big, important games, but you know, we're approaching both of these games calmly, like we have done all games. You know, we've looked at the opponent and we've assessed ourselves from Saturday, and you know, there'll be plenty of focus there. We know there'll be two difficult games, two teams that have started the season very well. But Bromley first, you know, they're on the back of a couple of results that will be, you know, disappointing from their angle, and they'll be looking to put that right. So, you know, like when we had a little blip, we come out of it. At some point, Bromley will come out of their little blip. But what I hope is it's obviously not tomorrow, because we're going to be on our game and on the back of a little run that we've put together ourselves now, where we're back on track. So it's just important that we go into these two games, and like I always do, we touch on what the opponent's about, but the majority of my focus is on what we're capable of doing, and that's what we're looking at for tomorrow and Saturday.
Do you welcome being back at the Hive after two away games now?
Yeah, I mean, listen, Dagenham's not a million miles away, is it? So that was a derby as such as well. And the fans come out in numbers, and obviously I appreciate that, but then you know, the 23-24 that come up to Fylde as well witnessed a really enjoyable evening that night. So you know, they've followed us on the road over the last week, and now it's an opportunity to get them back behind us at the Hive and take advantage of two home fixtures.
We had the likes of Medialito, Dave Tonder back in the squad. Dave's getting a few minutes now. And obviously we've had the likes of Elliot Johnson, James Dunn haven't played in a while. What's the squad looking like going into this one?
Yeah, I mean, what we've had of late with Sweeney, Harry Taylor, Mauro is boys that have been out for a long period of time, and then they've played sort of 390 minutes or three games, let's say, maybe not all minutes, but three games over a short space of time, and it can sometimes catch them up a little bit. So we've got to be mindful of managing them back to like full 100% fitness. And then what you've got coming up behind them is Elliot Johnson is maybe, I'd say, we're hoping he'll be back on the balls next week. Just got to get another scan to just make sure he's where he should be. And then he'll be back on the balls. Andre's getting closer to being back around training as well. Dunny is just breaking all sorts of rules at the minute, because he should have been out for a large period of time, but he's chomping at the bit, and he is hopefully only maybe 3 weeks away, but he'll be back on the grass. He's doing some work with a physio at the minute, but he'll be back on the grass and with a group hopefully in the next fortnight. Charlie Adams trained today, which was a plus after his injury that he picked up at Halifax. So yeah, we're slowly but surely getting one or two back. Sparksy's probably the longest term out of all of them. But yeah, they're slowly but surely getting back. But one or two of the others that have come back recently, and then, you know, we just got to be a bit careful with them, little niggles and that, where they've been out for a period of time, and now they're straight back in the firing line, aren't they? So just got to be careful.
Do you look forward to having a selection headache?
I can't wait because what it'll allow me, because I truly believe in these boys, it'll allow me to play all systems, all personnel. I'll have a strong bench, you know, people will know they've got to work hard to keep their shirt, and that's healthy competition. And what I like about it is, you know, with this group, they're tight knit, they're all together and they all back each other, which is nice, which is why, you know, Saturday, for example, most of them come along to the game because they want to be behind the team and around the players. So I like the togetherness they're showing. And the more of them that are out on the training pitch, you know, the competitions will heat up and they'll all be fighting to be in the team. And that's exactly how I want it.